गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम इन एचसीपी लेक्चर। टुडेज आई विल स्टार्ट द लेक्चर ऑफ हॉस्पिटल एंड क्लिनिकल फार्मसी इन दैट चैप्टर नंबर 8। रिमेनिंग पार्ट ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 8 चैप्टर इज ड्रग इन क्लिनिकल टॉक्सिसिटी। ओके, लेट अस फर्स्ट शॉर्टली लुक एट व्हाट वी सॉ इन प्रीवियस लेक्चर। अप टू द heavy metal poisoning. Okay, first introduction, then classification of poison, then general treatment of poisoning, then insecticide poisoning, then heavy metal poisoning. Okay, I will revise the previous part of this chapter. First introduction. In introduction we have seen the poisons are generally used for the suicidal purpose, then poisons are used for the homicidal purpose, then poisons used for stupefying purpose. Then classification of poisoning, in that first is corrosive and second irritant and third is neurotics. Then irritant, for example of irritants, first is organic, second inorganic and third is mechanical. Organic again can be divided into the two types. First is vegetable poisons include castor oil, colocynth, then ergot, marketing nut and alloys. And second is animal poisons consist of the cantharides, snake venom, scorpion venom and poisons insects. Then next point is general treatment of poisoning. In that the victim needs immediately treatment. It involves the following measure. First is immediate care of deteriorating body functions, then removal of the unabsorbed poison, then elimination of absorbed poisons, then use of the antidotes and supportive measures. Then in that systemic antidotes, such substance produce the opposite action of effects that of poisons. These are administered with care because antagonism always not complete. The antidote itself may produce the unwanted effect. Example, bal, that is dimercaprol and EDTA salt, etc. Then next point is insecticide poisoning. In that, first is organophosphorus compound and DDT. First, organophosphorus compound, in that we have seen the symptoms, treatment, then use of and other measures. Use of choline esterase inactivator and other measures. In treatment, first step is decontamination, then emesis, then gastric leverage, then antidotes, use of choline esterase reactivator and other measures. Okay, then next point is heavy metal poisoning. In that, first is arsenic poisoning, second lead poisoning and third mercury poisoning. Okay, the lead poisoning and arsenic poisoning we have seen in previous lecture. The in arsenic poisoning, acute arsenic poisoning, then symptoms, treatment and chronic arsenic poisoning. Then in that, first is acute arsenic poisoning and a chronic arsenic poisoning. In that, symptoms of both and treatment. Then next is lead poisoning. In that, acute poisoning and chronic poisoning. Then symptoms of both and treatment. Okay, now see the next is mercury poisoning. Today's part, that is mercury poisoning. Mercury poisoning, the environmental pollution is the source of mercury poisoning. The workers working in miner, then thermometer, barometer and electrical industries are exposed to this poisoning. Then acute poisoning, in that symptoms of acute poisoning, first is metallic taste in mouth, then inflammation of gingival, then white coating on tongue, then burning pain in GIT, then hematuria and albuminuria, then cardiac arrhythmias and convulsions, etc. Then treatment, first is gastric leverage and artificial respiration, then charcoal eggs to prevent the further absorption, then alternatively penicillamine may be used. Okay, then next is chronic poisoning. contaminated diet of fish. Then it is major source of the chronic mercury poisoning. Then symptoms. Now see, chronic poisoning in that contaminated diet of fish is the major source of the chronic mercury poisoning. Then symptoms, first is excessive salivation with the inflammation of salivary glands, then brownish blue lines on gums with loosened teeth, then GIT disturbance, then tremors of tongue and fingers. Then treatment is the removal of patient from the exposure, then enhancement of mercury excretion. Why? Kidney. Then dimercaprol as an antidote, and use of the anticholinergic is 30 to 40 mg in the 3 days to reduce the excessive salivation. Okay, these are the mercuric poisoning. Then next is barbiturate poisoning. This compound are mainly used as sedatives and high hypnotics. Barbiturate poisoning mainly used as the sedative and hypnotics. They wear are also used as the antipsychotics and anti-epileptics. Barbiturates are used as the sedatives and hypnotics. They also used for the antipsychotic and anti-epileptics. Okay, now see the symptoms of that. First is may cause the excitement, then restlessness and mental confusion, then slow speech and delirium. Then respiratory depression, hypertension and muscular weakness, then coma, finally dead due to the respiratory failure. Okay, these are the symptoms of barbiturate poisoning. First is may cause excitement, then restlessness and mental confusion, then slowed speech and delirium, then respiratory depression, hypertension and muscular weakness, then coma, finally dead due to the respiratory failure. Then next is the treatment of the barbiturate poisoning. In that, gastric leakage by using potassium permanganate solution or suspension of charcoal. Then hypertensive like metaminol in the dose of 2.5 mg by IV may be given. Then use of the analeptics which stimulate the CNS. Then use of the use of the forced osmotic diuretics, diuretics like monitol 20% of 500 ml solution. These are the treatment of the barbiturate poisoning. First is gastric leakage by using potassium permanganate solution or a suspension of charcoal. Then hypertensive like metaminol in a dose of 2.5 mg by the IV may be given. Then use of the analeptics which stimulate the CNS. Then use of the forced osmotic diuretic like the mannitol 20% of the 500 ml solution. Okay, then next point is narcotic poisoning. In that, this group of the poisons is also known as the somniferous. Their preparations are used therapeutically to reduce the pain and produce the sleep. Okay, these preparations are used therapeutically to reduce the pain and produce sleep. The main poisons in which group are opium and pithidine. Then opium is obtained by the incision of an unripe fruit of poppy plant called as the papaver somnifera. Okay, then symptoms of opium poisoning can be categorized in the following stage. First stage is stage of the excitement, second stage is stage of spores, and third stage is narcosis. Okay, now see the first is stage of excitement. In that, initially well-being and comfort with pleasurable mental excitement, then less for very short duration, then euphoria later with increased heart rate. Okay, these are the stage of excitement. Then stage of the spore. The stage of excitement is followed a headache, then giddiness, a scene of weight in limbs, then strong tendency to sleep, etc. Then third stage is stage of narcosis. In third stage, patient goes into the deep coma. Blood pressure falls. Okay. Then these are the three stage of the symptoms of opium poisoning. Then treatment, the gastric leakage with water and potassium permanganate solution in ratio of 1:1000. Then purgative like magnesium sulfate 15 ml orally can be given. Then 1.5 mg atropine can be useful. Then artificial respiration may be given. These are the treatment of narcotic poisoning. Okay, here are completed the chapter number 8, that is drug in clinical toxicity. Okay, and here are the important questions related to this chapter. And after watching this video, you all students are able to answer this question. Okay, now I will stop here. Thank you.